Bueno, mi gente, vamos a hacer una receta de chicharrón, pork belly. See how nice that is? Yes, we're making pork belly today. Hoy vamos a hacer chicharrón con un poco de arroz blanco, gandules guisado con bolitas de guineo. Pero aquí la receta es el chicharrón. Vamos a hacerlo suavecito, fácil, sin tanto apuro. Vamos a empezar. We're gonna do it quick, easy. Let's start this video. Let's go. Bueno, mi gente, vamos a hacer estas. ¿Cómo le puedo decir? ¿Chicharrón? Claro, chicharrón. Lo que no se le puede decir de otra manera. Estos son chicharrón. En Puerto Rico, nada más si el cuero está bien, pero estos son chicharrón con barriguita de puerco. Las corté. ¿Usted la ve? Que es carne frita. Entonces así lo hacemos, el chicharrón con la carne frita, pues tiene su carne. So, this is the pork belly, and I cut it. And in Puerto Rico, we call it chicharrón. That's what we call it. Carne frita. That's just what it is. And it's delish. I can't have it, but I know it's delish because I used to eat this all the time. Let's get this real. We're going to season this real up. Vamos a sazonar esto bien rapidito. Vamos a dejarlo por 24 horas en la nevera. Y luego a freír, que se ha dicho. Vamos a adobar nuestra carne ahora mismo. Lo quiero hacer rapidito. Esto es 1, 2, 3. Sazón. Let's get our sazón into our pork belly. A lot of people don't use it. Somehow we Latin people do. If not, we use achote to it. It's just our way of doing stuff. To get that redness into the skin, into the meat. It's just it's amazing. So we're going to get this. And you're going to rub it on. Remember, always rinse your pork with vinegar. Siempre, por favor, enjuaguen su carne de cerdo con vinagre. Siempre. Yo lo hago por lo menos 10 minutos. Siempre lo enjuago con agua fría y vinagre. Siempre, 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 siempre. No, I can't stop doing what I do. That's just how I like things. Adobo. Use adobo accordingly to what you think you need. Usen el adobo dependiendo como te lo necesiten. Recuerden que el adobo sí sala. It does salt a lot. So, I'm not going to use a lot. So, you saw me using a tablespoon. Ustedes vieron que usé una cucharada para dos pedazos. Because later I'm going to put some salt into the skin to fry it up. Once it comes out of the refrigerator. Well, probably I do it now so that way I won't forget. But in the skin, I always put some salt. Why? Because I want it real crunchy. Pero mi carne has to have this adobo. Now that I have my meat and my pork seasoned up. Okay, now we're gonna go with my garlic paste. As you see. Let me get a tablespoon. We put garlic on everything. I know I do. But it gives it a taste. Yo le pongo ajo a todo porque le da un sabor tan rico a las cosas. So, two to three tablespoons because that's how much I use. And with that, sofrito. Two tablespoons of sofrito. That's it. Because you got the garlic that's going to give it that taste. Now, rub that baby. Ahora póngale todo ese ajo y todo ese amor. Su carnecita. Mi gente, esto está para chuparse los dedos. ¿Ustedes no están viendo esto, mi gente? Esto está fabuloso.
Ahora, quitándome un guante solamente, porque tengo que cortar el papel de aluminio, voy a coger la sal y se lo voy a poner encima del cuero, un chin, porque queremos que cuando vaya el sartén o vaya la olla, ese cuero se ponga bien tostadito. Y mientras está en la nevera, va absorbiendo esa sal. So while we put in the salt, what's going to happen is that skin is going to absorb the salt. And when you fry, it's going to be really crunchy. And that's what I want. My pork belly. My God, my mom used to do this so much. My dad used to like it. Because my grandma used to do it a lot outside. They would kill a pig and we had chicharrón, pork chops. You name it, we had everything. Except I'm not a mochila lover. That, my people, I will not do. Sorry. I could do other sausages, but no. Okay, and this is it. This is it. And now, it's going to go no whiskey. I know you guys are asking, she's not putting whiskey in it? No, no whiskey. This is a traditional way that my mom did it. With nothing else. And now we're going to put aluminum foil over it. And call it wonderful. 24 hours in the fridge. And that is it. We shall be back tomorrow while we fry this. Volvemos para atrás. Vamos a dar las 24 horas. Y volvemos para atrás, mi gente. Bueno, mi gente. Ya hemos llegado. Con nuestra carnita que tiene que estar ahora súper, súper deliciosa. Estoy calentando el aceite. I'm heating up the oil. That meat has to be completely, no, it has to be amazingly. No, that's not a word for amazingly. It has to be scrumptious. Scrumptious. That's the word. It has to be like, wow. Wow. Delicious. Because it has all that seasoning from yesterday, all that garlic in there, that adobo, that sazón, that sofrito in there. I mean, and the salt in the skin, it has to be to the T. Le puse ese adobo, ese sofrito, ese ajo, ese cuerito con su sal. Eso tiene que estar a millón, mi gente. Esto tiene que estar a millón. Ay, qué rico. Para las personas que sí comen carne, que lo disfruten. Estoy calentando el aceite. Aquí hay 2 cups of oil. 2.5 cups of oil I have here. So, vamos a dejar que este chicharrón se cocine suavecito. Poquito a poquito, pero suavecito. Y lo vamos a dejar quietecito. We're going to leave it alone. We're going to let it cook. Let everything cook on its own. And one of the things que mami siempre hacía, una de las cosas que mami hacía, mami le bajaba un poco el fuego para que se cocine y luego se lo subía para tostarlo. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring down the fire, but that's one of the things my mom used to do. She used to bring down the fire and she just let it cook. Let it cook in its fat and that oil. That's it. That's the secret to a good chicharrón. You know, if you go to Puerto Rico, they have these big calderos, these big pots, huge pots of lard, and they fry the pork chops and everything in there, but they cook everything in not high heat, slow heat, so it can start cooking. I mean, it's I'm telling you, it's amazing. Now, if you're doing chicharrón, it's a different thing. You know, chicharrón is always like a medium-high heat, so when, you know, you have to have a deep one for that one, because chicharrón starts splatting everywhere. Like, seriously. So, we're going to cook this. And cooking it, I would say a good 25 minutes. So, we're going to cut those 25 minutes while that's cooking slow and surely. It's going to be amazing. Will I put a lid on it? Sure, I will. I will put a lid on it for 5 minutes to 7 minutes. Le voy a poner la tapa al caldero para 5 o 7 minutos y después lo destapo. That's what we're gonna do. Para que se cocine tender. Don't touch it. Leave it alone. 7 minutes. Let's leave it there. And then we'll see how it looks. It has to be tender, tender, tender. Then we'll crank up that heat so we can have it crisp. Vamos a dejarlo ahí por los 7 minutos. Que esté blandito, rico. Luego subimos el fuego para arriba. Mi gente, eso es todo. Eso es un wrap. Eso está ahí. Chicharrón. Bien frito, como le gusta a mi familia. Bueno, volvemos para atrás en 7 minutos. Bueno, mi gente, let's check those 7 minutes. Vamos a ver cómo se ve. Oh my God, that smells so good. Let's take a look. And we have to touch it. Pork. Soft. If it's soft to the fork, it's soft for you to bite into. Now, it's time to crisp it up. Let's make that chicharrón. Let's bring up the fire. Okay. Now we're going to bring up this fire. The pork belly is not rough, so you don't have to worry. Sometimes, if the pork belly is big and you cut it in big fat chunks, I will sometimes boil it with the adobo and have all the tasting, and then the only thing I gotta do is let it dry and then fry it to a crisp. Easy to do as well. Cuando, si la barriga del puerco, yo la corto bien grande. Vamos a suponer que yo compro una rebanada bien grande, entonces lo quiero hacer en pedazos bien grandes. Entonces lo que yo hago es que lo pongo en ajo con sofrito y todo al hervir con sus sazones. Luego lo saco después de 10 minutos, lo dejo secar y después lo frío en sus aceites y queda igualito. So, depende cómo usted quiera hacerlo. Pero ahora le subimos el fuego y ahora se va a tostar, se va a dorar. Eso es lo que queremos. Hice un arroz blanco, unos gandules guisados con bolitas de guineo. Por eso es que lo voy a servir. Vamos a dejar que eso se fría. Va a haber chispoteo porque es el pellejo. Ahí hay grasa, so claro que va a haber chispoteo. So, vamos a dejarlo así ya al son de Diana, como digo yo. Y que se fría. Y volvemos acá cuando ya esté casi bien doradito. Ya, mi gente, este chicharrón ya está. Vamos a sacarlo para afuera. Bueno, mi gente, ya esto tiene que estar para salir afuera ya. Vamos a sacar la tapa. Ajá. Ve, lo ponemos bajito para que se tueste, para que se ponga bien tostado. Siempre tiene que tener cuidado que no chispotee. So we put it very low so it could get to this point. If you put it high, it's going to burn and it's not going to be okay. You have to cook it slow and good. Mm-hmm. And I have my chicharrón done. Ahí está mi chicharrón. Así lo que lo queremos. So, mi gente, aquí está el chicharrón. Miren qué lindo. Look at my pork belly. It is beautiful. That's the ball of banana that I was saying. And this is the gandules. It's amazing. And of course, we have to have some Puerto Rican hot sauce. Pica. It comes with all the peppers in there. But I bought this. I usually make mine, but I had to get one. So, that's it. Eso es. Un arroz blanco, candule guisado y bolita de guineo con chicharrón. Now, let me show you how crispy this is. Déjame enseñarte. Vamos a ver si lo ponemos. Mm-hmm.
Yo soy loca con el chicharrón. Pero, see how crispy that is? Oh, God. I'm tempted, but I will not do it. Because I cannot eat meat. That is no good for me. Pero, a todas mis personas que sí les gusta la carne, que le aprovechen. Mi gente, mandando saludos a todo el mundo, everywhere. Vamos a continuar haciendo video. Continuar haciendo simples videos, porque ustedes vieron. Pork belly is very simple to do, very easy. Just a few ingredients and that's it. Always cook it slow heat. Never high heat. You cook it high heat, you're going to burn it and you're not going to enjoy it. Low heat and you're going to have a beautiful piece of pork belly. Delicious. Vas a tener un pedazo de chicharrón riquísimo. Siempre a fuego lento. Mi gente, se les quiere mucho. Vamos a empezar este año con el pie izquierdo afuera. Con las bendiciones de Dios. Que todo el mundo se cuide, por favor. Los queremos mucho. Vamos a seguir cocinando. Yo soy una mujer muy simple con mi cocina. Y le trato de tratar el simple platillo. I'm a very simple woman and I'm trying to bring simple recipes. So what you guys can do. It's not a, you know, it's not hard when you love cooking. And I love my cooking. I'm also going to bring vegetarian, vegan food. And you're going to like it. My next video will be a vegan rice with broccoli and garlic. It's going to be amazing. And chickpeas. You're going to like it. El próximo arroz que voy a hacer va a ser un arroz con broccoli, con garbanzo, ajo. Ustedes le va a encantar. Bueno, mi gente, hasta la próxima. Se les quiere un montón, un montón, un montón. Cuídense, por favor. Déjenos los comentarios. Denos likes. Y suscríbanse. Give us likes. Leave comments that I will answer and subscribe. Until next time, YouTube. Bye.